Good morning, children. Today we are going to read about message writing from grammar section. It's for class 6th students English. So first of all, we come to know about what do you mean by message? What do you mean by the term message? So message is a short piece of information that is written for someone to whom you are unable to speak for some reasons. It's a short piece of information that is written for someone to whom you are unable to speak for some reason. Due to some reasons, when we are unable to catch that fellow, when you want to convey your message. At the time, we used to write a message. We used to convey our message or convey our piece of information through message writing. It can be defined as an important mode of communication containing some information, news, advice, requests, etc., sent by the messenger to the recipient. Messenger means who want to convey his or her message. Recipient means who is just receiving your message, from whom you want to convey your information. That's called the recipient, who is going to receive your information through message. Who is not present in the scene or cannot be contacted directly. If you are unable to contact directly to whom you want to convey your information or important news, notice, advice or information or request, something, then what we used to? We used to convey our information through message. So it cannot be directly connected. When you are not going to be connected directly, then you used to convey your information through message. So it can be defined as an important mode of communication containing some specific information or important news or advice or requests, etc. So it is sent by the messenger to the recipient who is not present in the scene or cannot be contacted directly. A message contains information which is short, exact and well organized. Sometimes the information to be included in the message is passed over telephone, or it can be based on certain written inputs. So a message has a specific way to transfer, like information which is short, exact and well organized. Sometimes the information to be included in the message is passed over telephone. Sometimes we just want to convey or we want to transfer our information through the telephonic message. So it can be based on certain written inputs. Here we have to see few important points while writing a message. What are the specific things we have to follow while writing the message? It can be says as guidelines for writing the message. Like, while writing a message, following things should be kept in mind. So we have to keep in mind the following things while writing message. A message is always written in a box. A message is always written in a box, means enclosed in a box. It should not exceed 50 words. So it has word limits, like only 50, cannot exceed 50 words. It should be written in the proper format. The message has a format. Still, we are going to see in our upcoming slides. So we should always try to follow that format while writing the message. So message will be always in capital letter. And is written at the center of the box. Message means heading. Message itself is a heading. So it is written at the center of the box. Before starting with the content, it should be underlined. It should be underlined. The word message, it should be underlined and written at the center of the box. Date, names of the sender, messenger, recipient, all are written on the extreme left side of the box, and time is mentioned on the right side of the box. Right side of the box. So, dates, name of the sender, messenger, recipients, all are just written on the extreme left side of the box, and time is mentioned on the right side of the box. So these are the important things we have to keep in mind while writing the message. So the information should be accurate and concise. Nothing should be added on one's own account. Sometimes we used to add or include our views. So that is not to be included a part of message. We have to see that the information should be given to him or her should be very exact and should be very in a proper manner. Message can be written as an informal or formal note. Message can be written on formal or informal note. So these are the specific guidelines which we can follow while writing the message. So these are the specific things which we can use to follow. So first of all, again I am going to repeat, a message is always written in a box. It should not exceed 50 words. It should be written in the proper format. Message is written at the center of the box, and before starting with the content, it should be underlined. Date, names of the sender, messenger, recipient, all the written on the extreme left side of the box. Children, just keep in mind, it should be written on the extreme left side of the box. Time is mentioned on the right side of the box. Time is mentioned on the right side of the box. And message always written in the box. Enclosed in the box. The information should be accurate and concise. Nothing should be added on one's own account. Message can be written as an informal or formal note. Both the things we can use, but it cannot exceed 50 words. We have to keep in mind, it should be written in the box. Message, like a heading, it should be written at the center of the box and it should be underlined. So just we are discussing about a sample message. What is the exact format of writing message? What is the proper way of writing message? Just we are going to see. Here I have given an example. You see, you are Reena. Suppose you are Reena, your brother Raghav's friend Amit. Who is Raghav's friend? Amit. So Amit called up to talk to him. Amit called up to talk to Raghav. But since he was not at home at the time, Raghav was not present at the home. So you took the message for him. Amit asked you to inform Raghav about a science class test of first two chapters to be conducted tomorrow. Also, he has to bring his science test copy. As you have to leave for your dance classes, you decide to leave a message. So at the time when Raghav's friend called him to talk to him, Raghav was not present at home. So what you did? You took the message for him. Amit asked you to inform Raghav about a science test. The chapters included first two chapters and it should be conducted by tomorrow. And also he has to bring his science test copy. But at the time, you also want to leave your home for dance class. So you decided to leave a message. So how you convey your information through message, let's we proceed on. We see that how we have to write the message. What is the exact format or what is the proper method of writing message? Children, here we are going to see that how we have to write a message. First of all, you put a box. You keep a box like you are seeing in a mustard yellow color. See, here is a message. You have to put the heading message in the center, at the center. Here little bit slipped off, but you have to put a heading in the at the center. So first of all, you write a message, then date in expanded form, then time, then heading. Here we can see the example. The word message, number one, point number one, you just observe. The word message is written on the top in the center. In capital letters, you always just observe in capital letters, and it should be underlined. It should be underlined. Number two, time is written towards the right. Time is written towards the right. Then point number three, date is written towards the left. Date is written towards the left. Point number four, body test. Who called, why called, follow up if required. Person who writes the message, number five. So this is the basic format of writing message. How you are going to write the message and what are the things where you are going to kept. So number one, the word message is written on the top in the center in capital letters and it should be underlined. Time is written towards the right, number two. Number three, date is written towards the left. Number four, body test, who called, why called, follow up if required. Then number five, person who writes the message. A message can be written or oral. Any of the ways we can use. It should be oral, it should be in a written form. And exact format of message, if we see, point number one is heading. Point number one is heading. Number two, date. Always on the left side of the page in expanded form. Point number one is heading, means message in bold letters, underlined. Number two, date. Date should be always in left hand side of the page in expanded form. Then number three, time. Time should be both on the left and right side of the message. Time should be both on the left and right side of the message. Then number four. Four is what? Salutation. Four is salutation. Salutation means important to address the reader. when who wants to convey the message, that is called recipients. Means we have to address the reader, one is going to read your message. The number 5, body. Body means subject, matter, what you want to convey, that is called as body. Number 6, sender, who is going to send this message, means messenger. So mention your name on the left hand side of the page. Mention your name on the left hand side of the page, and after that include the message within the box. After completion of your message, what you have to do? You have to enclose your message within a box. And the words should not be exceed 50 words. It should be 50 words. Here we can see, and I'm going to discuss you few of the solved examples of message writing. See, do practice. Let's go through that. Here, children, you see what the question is asking to you. You are Anita or Anish. You stay in hostel and share a room with Meeta or Manish. Your classmate, they are your classmate. So you are in hostel and you just share a room with Meeta or Manish. They are your classmate. You have been detected with typhoid fever and some other complications. For this reason, you have to be admitted in hospital immediately. Due to your health issues like typhoid fever and some other complications, you have to admit in the hospital immediately. So, what you have to do? Draft a message telling your roommate why and where you are going and that you will be back in 7 days. You need to convey your message. You need to transform your information to your homemates or roommates. So also request him or her to submit your maths notebook for checking. So you have to leave your hostel due to some reasons. You are just going to admit in the hospital due to your critical issues of your health. So you need to transform your information through message to your roommates. So what you have to do? You have to do is what? You are going to convey your message through information through message writing. So now you used to write a message. So this is the way to transform your information in written way. So here box is not there. Children, you have to put a box and you just underline the title, that is heading message. So here message, time and date. You are going to share your information to Meeta. She's your roommate. So I am going to the hospital as I have been detected with typhoid fever and some other complications. I will be admitted in the hospital for 7 days. Please submit my maths notebook for checking. Anita. So recipient is Meeta. Messenger is Anita. So here we have seen the example of message. How you are going to write a message. Another example we have to see. You are Anita. You have appointment with your friend Srishti to see a movie at 3 p.m. but you have to take your father for an urgent medical checkup. Before leaving, you decide to leave a message for your friend to book the movie tickets for 5 p.m. show. So, draft a message. You have to leave a message for your friend to book the movie tickets for 5 p.m. show. First, you have time to watch the movie by 3 p.m. But at the time, you have to take your father for urgent medical checkup. So, you need to change the time. So, you want to convey the message to your friend that to book the movie tickets for 5 p.m. So, draft the message. Here we can see how we have to draft a message. Again, children, you have to keep in mind that message always written in the box. Message should be in bold, in capital always, and should be underlined. So here we can see, Srishti, I have to take my father for an urgent medical checkup, due to which I will not be able to go for the movie today at 3 p.m. Please book the movie tickets for 5 p.m. show. Children, as we read in our previous slide, that it should be, message should be passed in telephone too. So, I'm giving you an example orally, like suppose you are Raj. Today you had the following conversation with Rakesh, a friend of your elder brother. So Raj, hello, it's 9912345 09. Rakesh, yes, I am Rakesh speaking. What can I do for you? Raj, well, Rakesh, I am Raj, you know, your brother's friend. Rakesh, oh, I see. Well, brother is not here now, so can I help you? Raj, could you please convey him that he should bring my practical book today in school, as I need it is in class today? Rakesh, that's fine. I will do that. So, as you are leaving for your school, write message for your brother in about 50 words. Put your message in a box. So, still he is going to write a message in the box. So, what we do? First, we should write a message in the center of the box, then date, then time, then address to the recipient. So, Raj called in your absence. He wants you to bring his practical book to school today. He said it's urgent and he needs it. Then, Rakesh. That's it. So, message always try to write in a very short and exact manner. The word should be very specific. Here, it's a telephonic conversation. Just to see an example. You receive a phone call from your mother's friend, Mrs. Rakhi, in her absence, and have the following conversation with the speaker. Write a message for your mother as you have to go for your tuitions. Put the message in a box. Mrs. Rakhi, hello, is this 2525864? Smriti, yes. May I know who's calling? Mrs. Rakhi. I am Mrs. Rakhi. Can I talk to Devika? Smriti, I am afraid. Mother is not at home. Do you have any message for her? Mrs. Rakhi. Yes. Please tell her that the kitty party fixed for tomorrow on 25th of January has been cancelled. Smriti, it has been cancelled? Mrs. Rakhi, that's right. Also tell her that I shall let her know as and when the next date for the party is fixed. Smriti, okay, auntie, I shall tell her. So this is the telephonic conversation in between Rakhi and Smriti. So let's see the format of writing message. Message in a box in the center. So message, time 10 a.m. date, then mama. She used to convey the message to her mother. So mama, salutation. Mrs. Rakhi called in your absence, stating that the kitty party scheduled for tomorrow, 25th of January, has been cancelled. She also said that she would let you know as and when the next date, sorry, here data, date, E is there. Instead of A, you put E. Next date for the party is fixed. Smriti. So this is the way how you used to write a message. You have to convey the message. One who is not absent, sorry, one who is not present at the moment when someone wants to speak to you. Here, two of the questions I put, you need to do it as assignment. Let's practice. You are Anita or Anish. You stay in a hostel and share a room with Meeta or Manish. You're a classmate. You have to visit your hometown Jabalpur to attend your sister's wedding. Therefore, you would not be able to attend school for 10 days. Draft a message telling your classmate about your visit and request him or her to submit your leave application to your class teacher. So this is your first question. You need to write a message. Number two, the following is a telephonic conversation between Mr. Kumar and Mr. Sharma. As Mr. Sharma is leaving the shop early, he leaves a message for the manager, Mr. Dua. Read the conversation and write the message. So, Mr. Kumar, hello, can I talk to Mr. Dua? Mr. Sharma, he has gone out on business. Can I help you? Mr. Kumar, I am Kumar. All the electrical goods supplied by your firm were delivered. However, it was found that 5 pieces were damaged completely. Please ask him when he can get them replaced. Also tell him that I will make the payment after all the goods have been replaced. Mr. Sharma, I will inform him when he comes back and will ask him to get back to you. Mr. Kumar, thank you. So you have to need to read the telephonic conversation properly and just write a message. Leave a message to him. So this is all your message writing. Children, hope you understand the proper way, the proper format of writing message. Thank you, children, for watching. Thank you.